All right. Happy Saturday, everyone. We have another broadcast of Project 365, which is a project that is under the nonprofit organization Trophy of Life. And this year, we are aiming to render 365 days of hope, encouragement, and inspiration. And as you know, Saturdays we dedicate to the next voice, the voice of the next generation. So we have a beautiful, beautiful guest I've had the pleasure to meet in person, and she is just as beautiful inside as she is outside. But before we bring her in, I just want to remind everyone to subscribe to our YouTube page. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. And I also want to bring in my most beautiful co-host, Erin Wilson.
Hi, everyone. Hi. I hope everyone is having a good day today. Everyone is staying safe. Everyone is enjoying this beautiful weather. Get out, walk, jog, do what you got to do. Take care of your errands. But today, we want to share our platform with Shamara Murphy. Hi, best friend. She's my best friend, guys. My best friend is here with me. Once again, my third best friend is here with me. She is an aspiring doc. She's getting her doctorate degree at Morgan State University. She is alum of Howard, right? Howard University. Okay, Bison. She is very active in church. She attends Miracle Baptist Church. She is a mother, she is a wife, she's a sister, she's a friend, she's a supporter. So she's here to render inspiration and knowing who we are and making sure that we stay rooted. So hi, best friend. Hi, Shamara. Hi.
Hi, thank you guys for having me. This is such a pleasure. I am excited to be here on this beautiful afternoon. And as Erin stated, I'm going to be talking about staying rooted in the motion, the importance of being true to who you are. And what I would like to add is whose you are. So let's talk about staying rooted in the motion. We all go through different motions, and motions could be whatever environment you're planted in at that time. So it could be school, it could be home, it could be relationships, it could be you just growing as a person. We're always going through motions. Right now, we're all globally experiencing this pandemic, which is another motion. The social injustice that is rising, that is another motion. But in all of these motions that are occurring, what is happening with us? How are we changing? And are we staying true to our morals and values and those foundations that we set upon ourselves? That's where the rooted come from. We need to stay rooted despite all the motions and all the changes that we go through. We need to stay rooted in our morals, values, and solid foundations. And in that, staying rooted, you need to be true to who you are. So I'll use myself for example. As Erin said, she done pretty much laid out my whole resume. But in each of those phases of my life, I have gone through different changes, becoming a wife, becoming a mother, being an undergraduate student to a graduate student and things of that nature, entering the working field. And in each of those arenas of my life, parts of me has changed and who I am, I elevated. And that is important. I elevated. However, my morals are still the same. God is always first. My solid foundation is still the same. And therefore, while I'm going through these changes and I'm going through all of these motions, I am still true to who I am. And even if the changes occurred and I got lost and I'm like, wow, I was this person the other day, but now I'm this person. As I tell my friends, I'm coming more Zen. I'm the Zen friend. I'm like, come with me, because that is rooted in I know whose I am. I am a child of God. I know that. And in me knowing that I'm a reflection of him, there is literally nothing that can move me but him, because I am rooted in that. So we have to remember our roots. because if we're not on solid foundation, we're on sinking sand. And if we're on sinking sand, we can be thrown in the midst of any and everything. And overall, stay rooted in whatever you're going through. Remember your morals, remember your values, remember those things that are important to you, your priorities, remember them. Because even in your ever-changing self, because like she said, I went to Howard, I used to be the party girl. I can honestly say that I used to be the party girl. I had fun on Howard's campus. But now I've been to law school, I've been to business school, I've been to all these different schools, and I've elevated in my life to the point of being that emerging adult to actually being an adulthood at this point. And some of those characteristics of myself are still the same, but as I said, I'm more zen now. And even in the changing of who I am, who I belong to stays the same. My roots and foundation stays the same. And that is important to have, especially with all of these changes happening in the world.
I definitely agree. First of all, thank you so much for sharing those thoughts. I definitely agree because, like you said, with everything that's going on, it is so crazy out here. Mm-hmm. And, you know, without everything we can go through ourselves personally, you know, our environments are just crazy worldwide. So it's so important to know where you stand, know who you are. And if you don't, people who are viewing this, or, you know, if when we share this, if you watch this, you know, if you don't know who you are, find out who you are. You have to believe in something. You have to stand for something. You have to be rooted, mm-hmm. like she said, in values and in principles, because if you don't, the way that the world is going right now, you'll just be swaying in the wind. You know, you'll just be going every which way. And that's not good for you personally. What do you think, Erin?
I agree. It's not good for us personally, you know, because we have to make sure that we are rooted. But, you know, I think it is okay, even for, I think, our younger viewers who are watching, and for our teenagers. It's okay if you don't know who you are right now. It's mm-hmm. not the end, like, it's not the end of the world if you don't know who you are, because I think it still takes time. Because I know it took time for myself to learn who I was, and to be able to stay rooted and grounded. Like, just because this person says something to me, like, I'm not going to be swayed. I'm just going to mm-hmm. remain true who I am. And it's okay if we do not reach that level of zen yet. It's okay, because we're still trying, you know, and in the midst of trying, you know, try to get to know yourself, try to do those small things. There's like little, I think, assessments, you know, on Google mm-hmm. or whatever, that you can just find, you know, of how to get to know. Ooh, okay. It's like different ways of assessments that you can do to, like, try to, how to get to know yourself, do YouTube videos, you know, there's crazy things. Like, I mean, I even said, you know, I think on live before, that sometimes I do the sticky notes thing, and then like the mirror, put it on the mirror, you know. I think those are also help, you know, to, if you like, okay, I'm beautiful, let's put I'm beautiful on the mirror, and that's, you start getting to know who you are. Like, you know that you're beautiful, you know that you're smart, you mm-hmm. know. So it's a day by day process. So Shamara, how do you balance, how do you really balance, because, you know, you listen, you know, you got many hats, best friend. You got many hats. So how do you stay balanced and rooted? Like, because I know there are some things that may come your way. You're like, oh my goodness, like, ah.
Yeah, so for me, the biggest thing for me is self-care. Know yourself. And like how you said earlier, Erin, it's okay of not knowing who you are, but you know who you are not. If you know who you are not, you can build upon that to really discovering who you are. But as far as time management, I have like this much OCD, if I'm honest about me. I do. I have like this. Okay. So some people may say like this much, but I'm going to say like this much. I have like this much OCD. And I am a planner. I can say that I've always been a planner. And I work best in habits. So for me, staying, you know, managing my time starts at my root. So I wake up in the morning, and that's a part of my self-care. I wake up in the morning and I pray. I pray over my husband. I pray over my kids. I pray for my family. I pray for my friends. I meditate. I literally take that time to listen to, you know, God and say, God, what do you want me to do today? I ask, funny thing is that I actually watched you guys live two Saturdays ago when Aaron was talking about effective and planted, I was the friend with the five things. That was me. So I asked God, like, literally, tell me the things that you want me to do today. And if I accomplish five of them, I'm successful. If I accomplished five of them, I did what I was called to do today. If I made a difference. And I think that is literally the root of me managing my time, just knowing that I want to make a difference, having purpose. That is how I stay rooted, knowing that I have a purpose and knowing that God will never give me anything that I can't handle. And even if I feel like I can't handle it, because despite me looking like I got it together most times inside of know that everything is going to work out how it's supposed to be. For the younger generation, as far as time management goes, write out what you want to do for the day and stick to that as much as possible. And that works for, you know, this generation too, but like, write out what you want to do for today and stick to that and prioritize. For me, it's easier for me to knock out a bunch of little projects and then get to the bigger project. So prioritize that way, prioritize in ways that works best for you. I have a plan, I actually have several planners, but I have one main planner that has comprised everything that I have to do, from work, from school, from my personal life, family life, all of those things, church life, because I do a lot with my church. I work with the youth dance ministries. So it's a lot of planning that goes on in my end, and just plan. It could be one simple thing like, I want to wake up today and I want to make sure I make up my bed, as there's 24 hours in a day. If you make up your bed in 24 hours, because no one dictates your time but you. If you do that in 24 hours, you have accomplished your goal. It doesn't matter when you did it. It's the fact that you do it. That is the thing. Don't worry about when, because if we think about when, that's a worldly time and not really godly time. And let's focus on that.
That's great advice. Take it little by little. I'm telling you.
I say, that's all my best friend knows. Yes. That was, I always tap the screen when we on FaceTime. That was it.
Wonderful, wonderful advice. I just really want to thank you so much for coming on the broadcast today. You've given some like simple, plain, practical tips that are so important, you know, and sometimes we overcomplicate things. No, like, listen to what she said to do. This is how you can become successful. This is how you can find out what you like, what you don't like, and whatever phase you are in your life and becoming who you are. I just say, enjoy the phase that you're in right now. Don't get so caught up with, oh, I gotta get better. Oh, I gotta do that. No, enjoy where you are right now. Okay. One thing we can never get back is time. And you don't want to spend all of your time wishing you were something else, you know? So enjoy who you are right now. You will find out what you like, what you don't like, and just do whatever you do, give it 110% and follow those little tips that she said, and you are going to be gold. I'm telling you, you'll be golden. Aaron, do you have anything to say before we close out?
Well, again, we would just like to say thank you. Thank you, Shamara, for joining us in the broadcast. You did an awesome job. And I do believe our older generation, even our younger generation who are watching, will be able to walk away with those practical tips of, you know, learning how to plan in order to be successful. I think in order to be successful, period, we always have to have a bank. We always have to have a plan. We always, you know, have to have a battle plan before we go out into battle. We need to have a battle plan. We need to define it and all, but that's another. That's another topic.
But
Go ahead.
I was going to say, because Sakira brought up, you know, things change. I was like, Lord, that's another talk for another day. Because literally, when I think about my life when I was younger, right now, I'm supposed to have been an attorney. And granted, I worked in that field, but I was a dolphin swimming with sharks. And that is just me knowing who I am. And now I'm at Morgan. So sometimes we plan things in our life early on, and it may not work that way. But that doesn't mean that what you have coming is not greater than what you expected for yourself. Because sometimes we limit ourselves and put ourselves in these boxes.
That's good. Listen to what she's saying. That is good.
Yo, wise beyond her years. Wise beyond her years. Okay, miss. But again, thank you. Thank you to all our viewers who are watching. please, please, please make sure that you comment, you like, you subscribe to our YouTube page, and make sure you share on Facebook, because there, again, these are some good little practical nuggets that I think everyone should be able to listen to, put inside our toolkit and just run with it. So again, like, comment, share, subscribe, all of that. Again, we love you guys. We thank you. We greatly appreciate your ongoing support onto 365, or Project 365. I know Pastor Pusher really greatly appreciates every one of you guys and your thoughts, your prayers, your concerns, everything. I know she's grateful. So again, please, tomorrow, check us out tomorrow here on Facebook Live at 1 o'clock with our new guest. Please remember, stay safe, mask up, social distance, and have a good Saturday and be blessed. Bye, guys.
See you later.
See you later.